Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. Today I have started a new tutorial series in which we are going to learn how we can create a collection view step by step. In this series you are going to learn how we can create a simple collection view, how we can pass data, how we can resize the collection view, how we can show the multiple cells in a collection view, and how we can change the flow layout of collection view. Apart from that, I will show how we can create a scroll view, how we can create a scroller, image scroller, using collection view. So let's start. I have created a demo for that. First let's see that. So this is a collection view. It's a simple collection view. I didn't add anything else. So let's create something like this. If you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and let's create an app. Just open an Xcode project, click on single view application, click on next, click, give the name whatever you want to give. I'm just giving collection. Click on next, create where you want to create. Now go to storyboard. On a view controller, just type collection view, just drag and drop collection view over here. Now just give the basic constraints to this collection view. Now this is the collection view cell. We have to resize this collection view cell. So we have resized this collection view cell. Now we have to give the elements which we want in this collection view cell. So I want an image. And one label. So now just resize this image according to your need. I'm just saying 12. Or we can say 16 and 30, or we can also change it to 20. Now it's showing red because this constraint of this label is not set. Now set the constraint of this label as well. Now we already gave the constraint from the top. Now we only have to give the constraint from right, left and bottom. So this is 16. This is also 16. And bottom is 10. Now it's fine. Let's make this as a center. Now our collection view cell is prepared. In this first tutorial, in this first video, we are only create a simple collection view which showing a single cell on a controller. In the next video, we are going to learn how we can create a flow layout to show the multiple cells on a single view controller, in which we can create two cells in a row and three cells in a row. So let's first give delegates and data source. Now take one class of collection view type of cell type. It's a UI collection view cell, and give the name whatever you want to give. Data collection view cell. Now click on next, create it. Now go to the storyboard. Now give this class to this cell. First give the identifier, first give the cell. Data collection view cell. Now we have to give the name to this identifier. I'm just giving cell. Now go to the view controller and create outlets of all the elements in the storyboard. So this is collection view. Now we have to give the outlet of these two views in the cell class. So for that we have to open the cell class over here. Image. Label. Now Let's jump to the view controller. Yeah, now we have to give the data source, means we have to pass the array on which the data is going to fetch. So for saving the time, I already created the thing. So this is the array which I've already created. Now let's start implementing the delegate methods of collection view. So for that, I'm using extension. Just create a simple extension, view controller, collection view, data source, collection view, delegate. Now we have to write the required methods of collection view, data source, and delegate. So the first method is number of items. In this, we have to simply pass the number of cells which we want to create. So we have to pass the img array dot count, and the second is cell for item for row at index path, cell for item at row at index path. Now in this, we have to create one variable cell, and in this we have to pass collection view dot dq cell with reusable identifier. In the identifier, we have to give the identifier which we gave over there to that cell, just this identifier. We have to give this identifier, and in index path we have to simply pass the index path. So our cell is created. So we have to create this cell with data collections view cell type. So for that, we have to make it as, we have to typecast it as data collection view cell. Now we have to get the properties of that cell, but we are not, yeah, we are getting the properties image dot image equals to UI image named. We have to pass the string, the name of the image over here. So we have to use array of that image, image array. Collection view is almost similar like table view with more functionalities or more improvements. Now we simply have to return the cell. Now let's run. Okay, fine, we have to unwrap it. It's not showing any images. Why? Because we didn't pass the images in this assets. So for that, we have to pass the images, and I've already downloaded the images now. Let's run again. So all the images are showing now. That's the only thing which left is change the background color of this collection view. Yeah. So our collection view is ready. In the next episode, we are going to learn we can create multiple cells, one over here and the next over here, in collection view by using auto layout, flow layout. And this is for today. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you.